But there's only one guaranteed way you can have peace, and you can have it in the next second. Surrender.
I didn't think you had it in you.
I'm your huckleberry.
We will not go quietly into the night.
It is your killer instinct which must be harnessed if you expect to survive in combat.
You want answers?
I think I'm entitled.
You want answers?
I want the truth! You can't handle the truth!
It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward.
They will be met with fire and fury like the world has never seen.
Remember this day, Ben, or it will be yours for all time.
What keeps you awake at night?
Nothing. I keep other people awake at night.
Hey, it's Thursday night, episode number 68 of the Valken Debrief Airsoft live show. I am the Kaiju, the Supreme Commander of the Valken Alliance, and thank you for joining the biggest budget live airsoft show on the interwebs. So, man, tonight, I'm super excited about our show tonight. I'm just oozing with Christmas cheer. This is actually a Stormtrooper Christmas sweater. Courtesy of my good friend Airborne Tim, the Midwest Region Commander. Thanks, buddy. You rock, man. Helping me get into the Christmas season and supporting my love for Star Wars. We have a great show for you guys tonight. We're up to about almost 20 viewers. We see Angela Scott in the house, Brent McCullough, Travis Thornhill. What is up, buddy? My BFF Woodcock. What is up? We got Rich from Shrike Tactical, Ryan Dean from Nemesis Milsim, Chad Holt, 878 in the house. Look at that. Oh, JP, American Milsim. Heck yeah. We got Zero from X Customs and Breach Point Productions. We're going to be talking about a little bit about that later tonight. So thanks for watching. Please share the show. If we get up to 50 live viewers tonight, we are going to give away a luggage set of a duffel bag and a backpack. If we hit 50 live viewers, so hit that share button, tag your friends, get them in here. That duffel bag is huge. And look at that. We got Corey from Nemesis Milsim. He actually got to see the duffel bag at Reindeer Games a couple of weekends ago, and he said it's actually big enough to fit his entire sniper loadout. But don't worry, if we go past 50, we have 100 live viewer benchmark. If we hit 100 live viewers, we will be giving away a Valken ASL Mod M rifle with a rechargeable combat stock and stock dock charging station installed if we hit 100 live viewers. So please share the show. Get your friends in here. You don't want to miss out. We're going to have Brigade Milsim. They are getting the truck ready. And this thing is just amazing. I love it. Also, we have another tradition. The hammer comment of the night.
You can't say that on TV, bro.
So when you comment in the chat and you see the little hammer clip come up from our good friend Trey Sweeney, aka call sign Helljumper, that means you've made us laugh or you've been just so savage, but not enough to get banned because we like having fun here. We love having a good time and having a great time here. Marcelo from Steel Reapers, homegrown here, right here in Colorado, is watching us. So the hammer comment of the night will get their choice of a free t-shirt. Where's that t-shirt promo? I can never find it. It's somewhere. There it is. So if you win the hammer comment of the night, you get your choice of either a Join the Alliance Valken t-shirt or an As Seen on Valken Debrief t-shirt or any of the other Alliance custom tees that we have done previously. So But if you just want to help support the Alliance, all the proceeds for buying a t-shirt go right back into the show. They don't go back to the company, right here to the budget of the show to bring you the biggest budget live airsoft show in the interwebs. Travis Thornhill, Kaiju is watching himself. What? Oh my God. I got all these monitors. I got monitor one, monitor two, monitor three, monitor four. Normally I have monitor five, but Darth Valken is not here tonight. So we should tag Darth Valken and get him in here. I'm gonna tag him. Where is he at? Dropping the ball. Josh, we miss you. So, and finally, we also have another tradition. Gotta love it. It is the Overachiever of the Night. The first poster in the chat happens to be Angela Scott. She was the first poster tonight, and she's actually in a car traveling. But don't worry, she was not driving. Airborne Tim is driving, so she is not texting, watching, and posting while she's driving. So thank you, Angela, for being the first in here. So we're going to cut to a quick commercial break and bring in our special guest for tonight. So we'll be right back. Oh, wait, no. Sponsors. I got to talk about the Valken Alliance. Head on over to valkenalliance.com, sign up, hit the electronic sign up form, and then be sure to head back on over to Facebook to join your local region page. The Valken Alliance is about connecting community and just getting folks together in your local region to support the community, other players, and other teams. Tonight we are featuring the Rockies region. Gotta love the Rockies. I live here in the Rockies. Gotta love it. So, again, tag your friends. Get them in here. I can't tell how many people we have live because of my phone's glitching. 31. We're only 20 away. 20 away from giving away a luggage set. So, let's cut to a quick commercial and we'll be right back with our special guests.
Hi, it's Jonathan from Airsoftology. I'm really camera shy, but you're watching the Valken Debrief.
Welcome back to the Valken Debrief Airsoft Live Show, episode number 68. You can scoot in, it's okay.
No, I know.
I mean, you.
Well, he'll bite me and it gets weird and there's some touching.
What are you looking at?
I don't know. I'm looking at me. Sorry, I'm up here. Okay.
You got to look at Cinnamon. She's okay, behind the camera.
This is my first time. I think all these beautiful production assistants back here.
No, and I'm it's just Cinnamon.
At, just Cinnamon, that's it?
It's just Cinnamon.
Okay. Oh, okay.
Cinnamon. Woodcock actually helped me hire Cinnamon when I was in Oklahoma.
I mean, she is a lovely young lady, I have to say. Lovely.
We found her at a casino, one of those Indian casinos in Oklahoma.
So there is good things when you go to the casino in the middle of nowhere. You can actually find stuff you need.
That's right. So thank you guys for joining us tonight. Yeah,
this is a huge honor. Thank you so much for having us here. There's probably five people who know who we are, and now there's probably another 30 or 40, and we really appreciate it. Thank you so much.
I will write you that check right after the show.
You see that? See that? You can buy your way on the show. It costs you like $30. It's not a big deal.
So for those of you just joining us, we have Chris Seltz, Chris Nielson, which anybody that knows Brigade Milsim, you can't just say Chris. You're just like, well, which one are you talking about?
There's three of us. Yes. So what we're going to do real quick, because we're going to be talking about vehicle mounted operations.
Yep.
So we're going to create a poll to get an idea of what people would want. So let's see. The question is, what would be your preferred, I can even spell correctly, airsoft vehicle?
That's a tough one.
So I'm going to give them four options. I'm going to give them Humvee,
one pickup truck. One we've been looking at ambulances lately as maybe an option, too.
That falls under box van. We're going to put that under box van. Okay. Or just any miscellaneous vehicle with revolving turret. So we're going to publish that poll real quick, and we'll be able to see those results live.
That's cool.
Awesome.
So if you haven't ever seen a poll on the live show before, you can just swipe up. You'll see the poll if you're looking on your mobile phone, or if you're on your desktop, it'll be up here in the top right-hand corner in a little purple circle with some bars. You can answer the questions. We see your answers live, and then you can just swipe down or just click that icon, and it'll go back away, and you can come back to the show. So, man, people already answered. 75% say pickup truck.
Hey, that's what we went with. You know, it works great.
So here's a question for you guys who are choosing pickup truck. Basically, I mean, to preempt the question that's going to come later, designing a technical is for what you're going to use it for. And we kind of put it into three separate categories. So you have something, sorry?
We're going to have to wait on that
one. Oh, I'm sorry. I just was going to...
Dude, I know. You're excited.
I'm sorry.
I'm ready. So we got to get into the part of the show where the events...
Oh, I'm sorry.
We'll go. Because, so we're going to do events, because Chris is excited.
I'm pumped.
Super excited. And I didn't have to get him liquored up before this either.
I mean, there was some licking, but there wasn't any alcohol. Let's put it that way.
Oh my goodness. So tonight's events are brought to you by Command Decisions Paintball in Taylorsville, North Carolina. So right now it is time for the event update, and Chris are going to be helping me out with that.
I'd like to take the first one. I love these guys and I'd love to talk about
them.
Yeah, go for it.
So let's switch on over there.
So, Chad and Company, 878 Airsoft, Elk Gathering 5, December 15th. It's going to be in the southern region. So, if you're in Texas, Louisiana, Arkansas, Oklahoma, this is kind of a home event for you. Chad has a great field. He has a whole collection of airsoft vehicle stupidness. He has Humvees. He has half tracks. He has, I think, a tank at this point, and I think a spaceship or something. Like, basically, anything G.I. Joe made in the 80s, he's got on his field now.
He's even got a combat dog.
Does he? So he's got a firm missile to come chase you around.
Yes, exactly.
So if you get a chance to play on that field, meet those guys. They're great people. It's a great organization to support, and they put on great events.
And Op Gathering 5, you don't pay to get in. You bring toys to donate.
Oh, excellent. So
it's for Toys for Tots event.
That's an awesome thing.
That's even better. So, All right. You like SHOT Show a lot.
Oh, yeah. SHOT Show is awesome, and that's coming up January 22nd through 25th. That's going to be at the Sands Expo and Convention Center in Las Vegas, Nevada. Boy, that's an awesome, awesome place.
I've yet to. That's on my bucket list of things to do.
Oh, you got to go. You got to go at some point.
Definitely. Yeah.
To go as an attendee is great. To go as an exhibitor,
it's
very exhausting.
I would like to find a way.
You guys are going to be there, right?
Yes, we'll be there.
Awesome.
I think half and half would be the way to go. Like, know the exhibitors, but don't actually be one. That's kind of, I think, the best way to go.
We're actually... we're working to have a very cool centerpiece. We're working on it. We're trying to work on it. Let's just say it has to be, hint, Orange County Choppers, maybe.
Oh.
So
are we talking like a minigun mounted on a motorcycle or
something? I'm not going to say. We got another surprise coming because we're a distributor of Airsoft Innovations. They are finally finished. It's a brand new project. And we're going to be announcing it January 19th. Okay.
Mark that in your calendar.
We're going to have it at SHOT Show in the booth.
Okay.
And we're going to have Airsoft Innovations on the show during SHOT Show week, where people will be able to call in. They'll be able to see this brand new product and ask questions.
And you got the designers sitting right there.
Awesome. Yep, the designer's sitting right there.
if you have a problem with their product or you like it a lot, that's your time to get your voice heard.
Oh, yeah. I mean, exactly.
That's how a lot of people don't realize in Airsoft. I mean, like, these are normal people. They're not like superheroes. They're not unapproachable. And this is how products and stuff change. People build stuff. People talk about stuff. If you run into any of these people, that's how stuff gets made in the industry.
So, oh, Woodcock is going with the hammer comment.
What do you say?
SHOT Show. You mean adopt a gun bunny week?
Another cinnamon?
Another
what,
cinnamon.
What if you remember SHOT Show? You weren't actually there? Is that the thing?
Oh, my goodness.
You didn't have enough fun if you remember being a SHOT Show?
All right. Next event.
All right. You want to hit the next one?
I'll do the next one. All right. Operation Trench Knife. So this is going to be by Third Coast. I have not personally gotten one of their events. I've talked to a lot of people who've done their events and say they're a ton of fun. Watched some great videos from their events where people are doing all kinds of wild stuff. This one's going to be in Hattiesburg, Mississippi.
Camp Shelby.
Is that Camp Shelby?
That
Camp
is.
Shelby. That's Camp Shelby place. Should be a good place. That's going to be a good mix of indoor mount stuff in bigger areas because that's used to be a basic training location, if I'm not wrong, right? Camp Shelby or something like that?
They got a mount facility. They got Haji villages. They got runways.
Yeah.
So Sal Zuniga, military guy, does a great job setting those events up. But also longtime airsofter, Mr. Pope, who used to do Lion Claws and other events. He's working as part some of their game design. So what's really cool is you get to see different parts of the AO other than just that mount site. But it's segmented off. So if I remember reading it correctly.
So it's like playing on like 10 different fields all at once, but you don't play in between them.
No. Imagine, okay, have you been to Fort Hood?
Yeah.
Okay, you've got the three mount sites.
Ago, remember? We
oh, that's right.
We shot you got the boss guys, remember?
You
got...
You can scoot in.
I'm sorry, well, we're not on camper.
Okay, so there's three mount sites.
Yeah, okay.
So imagine Saturday morning, you're 4 hours on the north site, that's it. Then you have to transition and switch to like Boaz for the rest of the afternoon into the night game on day one. And then you switch to Elijah on day two. So what it takes an AO that is played at a lot by a lot of
hosts, it
provides a new thing, but it makes it more aggressive. It makes people move more because you know you're under a time limit. You're only in this location for 3 or 4 hours, and you have to move on.
Well, I'll tell you that's
or you know there's no completing the mission anymore.
I'm going to tell you that's going to be a great equalizer for newer players because there's groups like us, Nemesis, Raptor guys. We do a lot of planning. We do pre-looking at maps. We plan what's going to go on. And if you're just a player who's coming out to play, you're at less of a disadvantage to the more organized groups if you're seeing a new area every 2 hours. That should be a very interesting way to go.
Greg Alexander says Woodcock is a gun bunny. Woo!
He's a little too hairy to be a gun bunny.
I don't know. You haven't seen some of the gun bunnies.
I mean, it's been a while since I've been to one of those events.
Gun bunny doesn't necessarily mean pretties.
It just means likes guns.
All right, what's our next event?
It's all you, boss.
All right, next one. Looks like it's in the southern region. February 8th through 10th, Operation Icebreaker 3 Drug Runner by Battleborn Airsoft.
Oh,
it's going to be in Jonesboro, Arkansas. Oh, I'm not familiar with that.
Wasn't that where that cult leader, they drank the Kool-Aid?
No.
No, Carl Lindell runs Battleborn Airsoft and Battleborn Apparel. Okay. He was actually at Reindeer Games. He was playing for Cost.
Oh, I don't think I've met him yet. I've heard of. I keep hearing about Battleborn, and I'm just not plugged in enough. And I would love to know more about those guys.
He's, oh my gosh, he's got a lot of events scheduled. I think I want to say like 8 events, like next year in 2019.
That's a full schedule.
There's already hosts putting out their entire 2019 schedule. Most of them are of the first quarter. JP, get on it. American Milsim, we need that first quarter schedule, man.
JP, we got a planning meeting in 2 weeks, dude. I need information.
Exactly.
Planning meeting. Come on. You want us there? Give us the info.
Get on the train. So, but yeah, he's one of the fresh new faces providing scenario events.
And that's great.
It's great to see the sport growing.
I mean, It's sad to say that some of the older companies are going to have to compete a little harder now. But now that we have more choices and the sport is growing, it's only a good thing. I mean, it's this is having more options. And it's going to make everybody better at what they do. This is It's good to hear that.
Hey, Freddie Flux just joined us from Veterans for Airsoft.
Ooh. Good deal.
What up, Freddie? But it reminds me, you wanted to do a quick shout out.
I do
for
I
veterans.
Have an issue that's near and dear to my heart. I'm a veteran. Kaiju here is also a veteran. We both happen to be former infantrymen, so you know, we'll pound that out, little blue cord brotherhood. Woody, we
yes.
sit right in front of you. No
blue,
calves
blue cord, Corey.
Yes.
Get on that calf guy yes. Woodcock in the chat. Hashtag calf sucks.
So if you guys don't know, there's an issue that's been plaguing the veteran community, and it's mental health care. A lot more of us are coming back from the wars now. Vietnam and World War II, it was about 14-1 for injuries to dead people. Now more people are making it, so we're about 25-35-1 in terms of heavy injuries compared to death. And a lot of our guys are coming back with a lot of ghosts they can't find a way to deal with. I personally have lost 3 friends this summer to suicide, and one of the big things I like to raise awareness for is we lose, on average, 22 veterans a day. That's 22 young men and women who have devoted themselves to the defense of our country and defense of the Constitution, and in a lot of ways, they're being left behind. So this is not a political message for one side or other. Just please contact your representative, your senators, anybody, your local government, anybody who deals with veteran issues, and let them know that guys are dying out there still. The war is not over for them, and mental health care is a big deal. So just something I always like to
awesome.
Put out there. Thank you so much.
We had a question. Chad Errol, is there a calendar / schedule for the Airsoft games and tournaments? So, Chad, if you hadn't noticed, we are posting up the links for the events down here. But the Valken Alliance, we have region pages, 6 regions across the U.S. Join the Alliance, sign up, it's free. Join the Facebook group. And people in those groups are constantly sharing links to Facebook events in that region on those pages. So you'll be able to stay updated, meet some players and teams in your area. That's how you got to go about it. All right, what's our next event?
Is that my turn?
Yeah, I guess so.
Oh, I guess we are doing Centurion. All right,
no?
So, yeah. Ascension.
Yep, we're on Centurion.
Ascension de Verduga. Did I get that right?
Actually, you did it better than Woodcock did.
Did I? Okay.
2 weeks ago.
I'm okay with languages. So that's going to be February 15th and 17th. It's also a Southern Region event. That's going to be in Blakely, Georgia. Is that Guardian Center?
No. It's a different training center.
Oh, it's a different training site in Georgia? I don't know anything about that site, so I can't recommend it one way or another. I've heard great things about Centurion.
Yeah, it's run by Bubba Moore.
I was actually
former
just
Ranger.
Mention, I heard I've heard good things about Bubba, and the one thing I have heard about that event series is it's a no holds barred kind of event. They go real hard, and if you're looking for something that's a little more in your face, I've heard that's going to appeal to you.
Javier, the campaign is working. The campaign is working.
Now this is all hearsay. I mean, I can't vouch for it one way or another, but people I trust have said it's a good time. So. We'll go with that.
Yeah, we haven't done one from Centurion yet, but
no, we're looking at maybe
that might happen this year.
Might be on the schedule.
I can announce that they just released they are going to do the next. So this event is in February in Georgia. Their next event is May. Can't tell you the weekend yet, but I'm going to be in a command role coming out of retirement for command for Centurion Milsim in May. More details will come. You don't want to miss this. Like Freddie Flux, he's in the he's been to every single Centurion Milsim event.
I'm just gonna say, if you haven't been to a Kaiju party, Kaiju party rocks because Kaiju party don't stop. You know what I'm saying? Like it's a whole new level of airsoft if you're out there with Kaiju. I mean, there's chaos, there's maneuvering, there's cool technical terms. People say tango down. It's great. You're gonna love it.
Oh my gosh! All right, next.
Okay, next one. Looks like another at Camp Shelby in Mississippi, Hattiesburg. This one's by Milsim West. It's going to be March 1st through 3rd, the Chechen Collapse. And, yeah, Shelby's a real good place.
Everybody keeps, like, going back to Shelby.
Is that the one
they wouldn't keep holding events there.
That's the one with the big mosque.
Is it is that the one that also has the subway tunnels?
No.
The subway, is that Guardian Center? Or not the other
That's one. Guardian Center.
Okay.
Yeah.
I saw some videos of that. It looked really neat to run through those big, long tunnels. All right, so next we got Operating Shooting Star. This is going to be Third Coast Airsoft, March 1st to the 3rd. At Breachpoint Productions in Mineral. So is that a local field, Breachpoint?
So Breachpoint Productions is run by our good friend Zero from X Customs.
Oh, okay.
That is a Vietnam era hospital. Three stories and a basement. And it's haunted.
If any of you, you know, production people, owners are listening right now, you know, right here in Colorado Springs, we have a seven-story hospital sitting empty. Right over down by downtown, the old Penrose. Yeah, you know when
that's not being used anymore?
No, it's been empty for like 6 years. And they don't know what they're gonna do with it. It's got like it's three separate towers, 8 stories tall, about a 2-acre campus. It's right in the middle of downtown.
Ooh, that could be fun.
So if anybody
JP, tell Rick.
Just saying.
Rick wants in Colorado. Get here. Do it.
Oh, just saying.
Oh my goodness.
Oh boy. So after that one. Battleborn Airsoft in Jonesboro, Arkansas.
Again.
Yeah. Don't drink the Kool-Aid.
Looks like this one's Operation Red Rising 2. It's going to be April 5th through 7th.
I know some people who are going to be there. The famous Dave Gibson said he's going to that one and his Raptor crew.
Lots of purple smoke.
Yeah. Lots of purple smoke's going to be there.
A lot of purple in general.
They love purple.
Boy,
they manned up that purple
color. They flagged our truck with purple at Copperhead.
Yeah, they TP'd our truck at Copperhead. And then put a bandana on.
Oh, I don't think I shared that picture.
Dave's a lot of fun.
Oh, we drove around with that bandana on the antenna all weekend.
Oh, yeah. We were proud of that.
I think it made it back here to Colorado with us.
No, I returned it. He owes me. I've been promised an official Raptor bandana from that guy.
Okay.
And I'm still waiting for it.
Well, you got to follow up on that.
I'm shaming him right now on live TV. That's about about as public as I can get.
Yeah, you know? That's true. So, is that it for events?
I think so.
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, there we go. So if you want to get your event on the show, it's real simple. I mean, it helps that we're a sponsor. It helps. Just a little bit. But you need to have a Facebook event page. Because guess what? Then we can share that. People can click interested, going, get reminders. Anytime anybody posts, they get a notification.
Small donation to the Kaiju Fund doesn't hurt at all either. Just so you know, you know, care of Chris Seltz, Colorado Springs. I'll take care of all donations for him. Just send them right to me.
So that is how you get your event on the debrief. So we're going to cut to a quick commercial, and then we're going to come back. We're going to do a quick tour.
Yep. Outside.
We're doing
a remote camera operation. This is the first for Valken Debrief, right?
Yep.
Okay, we're doing first time.
Well, we did a test at AirsoftCon where Josh went outside to interview the people that had been camping for like 3 or 4 days prior to AirsoftCon.
That must have smelled very bad.
Hopefully we don't encounter any campers out there.
No. Oh. Yeah. So, and so I'm really excited. The truck is called?
Oh, internally we've been calling it like the ex-wife, but that hasn't really caught on. It's Chaos One.
That's Chaos One.
That's the usual call sign.
Yeah, Chaos One. It's on the tail.
Yep.
So we're going to cut to a quick commercial break. Get your questions ready for, we're going to be talking about mounted vehicle operations in airsoft games.
Yep.
You got two great subject matter experts, but we're going to get to a commercial. It's the event video. You're going to see it first live here from Fold a Gap Airsoft Scenario.
Ooh.
It's going to be live on Facebook.
Milsim West, right?
Or on live on YouTube, our YouTube channel, Valken Video, right after the show. But we're going to show that to them. You guys are going to get ready, and we'll be good to go.
Yeah, we got
to
go back to the green room and
get
dressed up and all that stuff.
This is House Gamers. You're watching the Valken Debrief. We'll be right back.
welcome back to episode number 68 of the Valken Debrief Airsoft live show. And we've got our remote cameraman outside with Chaos One and Brigade Milsim. You see Chris Nielson. Hey, wave hi, Chris.
Sorry about the lighting, guys.
Oh, it's okay. It's okay. I mean, it's daylight savings. It is what it is. So the guys are going to give us a quick tour of Chaos One. But be writing down your questions and get ready. They'll be coming back in after this quick tour. So, but I have a live feed. You can hear me okay? Big thumbs up?
Oh, yeah, we can hear you.
Awesome. So if any of you guys have any questions, I'll be able to relay that to them in the live chat. So, Chris, take it away.
All right. So we're outside the Valken Ranch here in beautiful 20-degree Colorado. This is a truck that we take to events. It's a 2004 Ford F-350 turbo diesel. We've done a few things to the internals to beef it up and make it more effective for us when we're on the field. We added a 250 amp high output alternator. We upgraded the oil cooler in it, put in a coolant system. There's a lot of power redundancies in it, not only to power all this electronic junk that you see on it, but if something burns out, if something shorts out, it's got to go through multiple stages before it ever causes a fire. So we've got multiple relays, multiple fuses along the way. Now, some of the exterior equipment that we mounted on this, of course, we have a brush guard push bumper up here on the front. I hope you can see this with the lighting. We have a Raytheon 300D. It's a thermal imaging camera. This broadcasts a thermal image to both the TC and the passenger seat. And then we have a screen that's up on that gunner shield, and the mounted gunner can then see what the thermal imager sees. We've got two mounted lights that are on the front of the truck. Now, those put out about 50,000 lumens of light when they're lit up. Just below it, we have our dead lights. We'll talk about that more here in a second. And 360 degrees around the truck, we've got 940 nanometer infrared lights. Some of these are covered by these little plastic guards. That thing's real stuck on there. We 3D print that in-house to protect them for when we're not using them. As we move around to the side, we have to protect certain things on the vehicle, like the reflectors. So we make some Kydex. And then we also protect the mirrors. And we use plexiglass for that. As you can see, that one's taking a hit. That needs to be replaced. I believe the driver's side's pretty shot up as well. Inside the TC's position, you can see up on the windshield, we've got a screen that's where the thermal imager is. And we've got a couple remotes on the dash. Those can control spotlights that can move, the thermal imager, that type of thing. We've got several radio jacks for our TC to use as well. Now, in the back, we typically have somebody in the back as well. We keep a fire extinguisher behind this seat, as well as one on the driver's side. And really, these guys are just back here for deployment. In the middle, we keep that bin. And in the bin, we carry things like speed loaders, extra ammunition, medication, toilet paper, anything that you're going to need out in the field. On top, we carry a BLS medical bag. And we have an AED, which is an automatic external defibrillator for our guys that are medically trained in case somebody gets hurt at an event. Now, while we're out in the field, typically at these events, we use about 15 gallons of diesel fuel through this thing just on the field at an event. Some of these some of the locations that we go to, like say Copperhead, is fairly remote. It's 150 miles round trip from us for gas station to event back to the gas station. So plus 15 gallons, we're almost out of gas. So we end up actually using diesel out of these cans at these events just to make sure that we have enough to make it back. Now, on the side, we mount a sked, which is, you can use it for dragging a body or an objective, that type of thing. We have a roll-up tarp, which is great for
airborne projectiles,
protecting you from anything raining down from above. On the sides, we have various markings, and we can change these event to event. It's not that fancy. It's magnetic that we use to slap that stuff on the vehicle.
Hey,
so
Chris,
that way we can modify it event to event if we need to.
Woodcock What's says that? Chaos One should be sponsored by NASA.
Please get on that. If you got to contact Woodcock, please make that happen.
All right, so in the back, we use a contractor rack on the sides. I mean, this is basically just plywood that's been coated with Plasti Dip and Flex Seal, that type of thing, to help protect the wood. We keep Gatorade bottles in the back for our guys for electrolyte purposes. We have pockets that we normally store bolt cutters in. We keep a map on the side, which is large. Now, this is also magnetic, so if we need to take it off and slap it on the side of the vehicle to do an impromptu field briefing, we have that. On the sides, we have holders for smoke grenade launchers and rocket launchers. We don't have those here today because the guy that's issued those is up in Wyoming, and that's hours from here. On the back, we have mounted air tanks. Now, we usually have a big one right here, and the two that are mounted below the gun. On average, through this awesome Polar Star M249, we'll shoot about 45,000 rounds at an event. This is enough air right here to get us through it. We only use this as a backup. We primarily go off of the little tanks that we can refill on site. And so when those go down, we just switch over to the big tank. So if we're in the middle of an engagement, that type of thing, we can't get back to refill the tanks. We don't run dry. So this gun is the M249 by, I believe it's Classic Army. It's got the Polar Star F2 engine in it. This thing is beautiful. Now as we move over, we've got breaching tools near the ground. Now there's a custom-built platform back here. We keep a Halligan tool, emergency water. We've got a dump bucket. We've got a box that we can put a LMG in. And then, we just got various other storage cooler capacities.
The cooler underneath.
Oh, yes, our cooler underneath. We keep cooling
water
towels in there.
Water is life, so ice, especially water, a broken home.
So if somebody needs to cool down in the field, they can just dip a towel in there, wrap it around their neck, feel a lot better. We keep sledgehammers, mounted smoke grenades, R2BS grenades.
And this is all for airsoft.
Back here. Typically in the back of the truck here, we have 8 guys. And so it gets tight.
So if you guys can see, Twitch is not wearing any gear, and he pretty much fills up the back of that. So imagine 8 more of him. We're not in the best shape on this team.
So as we move around, I hope you can see this in the dark. We keep a collapsible ladder here on the side of the truck. This thing, it weighs about 25 pounds. We got it equipped to an Alice backpack. And so that can be worn in the field. It expands out to, I believe it's like 13 and a half feet in height.
It'll go to a second story, no problem.
Yeah. Some events will mount a shovel on the side as well if we need that for something. There's been a few events where that's come up. Now, in the back seat,
we need lights.
Yeah, let me get the lights on.
Give us 1 second. We're just going to turn
Chris,
the interior lights on. You'll see everything.
Leo Lindell actually is asking a question. So what's the overall cost to build this massive monstrosity?
Okay, for
that's
this
a loaded question.
So, first of all, the labor that's gone into this doesn't, you can't consider that into this, but with the base cost of the vehicle and all the upgrades that we've put into it, we calculated it out. It's just a little over $38,000 that's gone into the vehicle.
So when you add about 2 or 3,000 man hours from qualified techs working on that, that bill kind of triples. So
in the back here, behind the driver's seat, you'll see that we have a black case. It's marked FLIR. That's a handheld thermal imaging unit. If we need that, that's great for finding if anything's been, any walls have been patched, if we're looking for anybody hiding in the bushes, that type of thing while we're out on foot. Above that, we have, above that, we have a borescope camera. So if we need to, again, look into a tight place, we have that. We can hold a couple grenades. And of course, we have a fire extinguisher that's readily accessible. Now, below all of that on the floor, we have a bin that we store a bunch of water in. Typically, there's about 30 water bottles that are stored in that bin, and that's ready for use for anybody that needs it in the field. Anybody that's been to an event with us knows that we drive around, we pass out water like crazy. That's where it comes from. So we can put water bottles in there. We can put some ice packs in there. Just makes it a lot easier. Now, as we move into the vehicle itself in the driver's area, boy, we've got a lot of stuff going on in here. We've got cameras that look back towards. We've got a virtual reality 360 camera mounted up. And behind our cameraman there, we got another camera in the back. Those of you that saw our massive fail from Broken Home 7, those are the cameras that recorded that awfulness. Okay, so right up here, we have basically what's a Blue Force tracker. We use a system that live maps. It shows us exactly where we are, and it can show us live on the event map where all of our guys are. So we can keep track of them live on this screen. Between the seats here, you can see there's a couple rifles. Those are mounted with little Kydex sheaths, and they hold the rifle in place. And so that just stores a rifle there for the driver and the TC so that they're readily inaccessible. Of course, we have the most important thing in here, cup holders, but down here in the center console is our control panel. And it's all touchscreen. You're going to have to listen to the door ding here for just a second as we power it up.
So this
was all built in-house, except for the screen, which, of course, we had to order and, you know, just some of the parts. But we built the entire thing in-house. It was programmed in-house. One of our guys that builds circuit boards actually made the circuit board that controls all of this. And from our control panel here, we can activate certain modes. We can monitor various status of the vehicle if we need to. We can put it into a field ready status, transit mode. If we want to dim it down for night, we can do that. We'll keep it bright so that you can see it.
Vehicle, hey Chris, I'm getting a lot of comments. People are loving the vehicle.
The side lights, the corner lights, the takedown lights.
What's up, Kaiju? They're loving the vehicle. And do you have any questions?
Steve Tom from Dark Horse 6 is saying, this is all awesome. All this awesomeness, and it only takes a tagging round to take it out. Hammer comment.
Well, yeah, I have an answer for that question and a good comment about that, about vehicle tactics when we come back in. I will answer your question when we come back in. Don't let them know that.
All right. So, yeah, you guys should be wrapping it up here and bring it back in because the comment section is blowing up. A lot of people are having questions.
Okay.
All right.
Cool. We'll see you in a couple minutes then.
All right. So we're going to cut to a quick commercial break, and we'll be right back to answer your questions.
Valken Sports is dedicated to excellent customer service.
Thank you for calling Valken Sports.
With this simple principle in mind and an industry-leading one-year warranty, Valken has grown from a single location to 13 distribution centers across the United States, Canada, and Europe. Fully staffed by skilled individuals, many of Valken's locations can assist customers with technical questions and warranty repairs. Valken Sports stands behind its products and is committed to delivering the best experience in the industry. To make this happen, Valken will do whatever it takes.
And we are back episode number 68. And Chris and Chris are back in the studio with us. Before we start, we want to log a quick. Hold on, we're getting an echo. We're going to cut the live video feed off. That was messing with us there.
No, it's not me.
No, I just turned it off, so now we're good.
Oh, okay.
Now we're good.
So here's the protest we'd like to log real quick, is that we were episode 68. We're really butthurt that we're not episode 69. I'm just saying, like, of all the goofballs to have 69, that would be us. Just saying.
So Angela Scott asks, my only question is, does it have road head room?
Well, when you're in full kit, no. It gets awfully tight in there.
But Darth Valken has given us some ideas for some products here at Valken that might be good for what we would call a Fifi back in the day, if you know what that is. And we figure if we just hang it under the steering column, we can make driving a lot more fun. Because no one ever wants to drive. They don't like getting shot up. I'm just saying.
Oh, my goodness.
Does that answer your question?
Yeah. James Lindsay asked, how many cup holders?
8.
Oh, let's see.
It's an American truck, man. They're everywhere.
Okay.
Yeah, I was going to say there's at least 6.
It's a good old American diesel.
So we're going to be opening up the phone lines. You'll see the phone number right there. You'll be able to call in live, and we'll be able to answer your questions.
A little crazy.
I know, right?
Those screeners are going to be busy. You guys have some serious problems out there.
Leo Lindell says, when in doubt, Chaos 1, whip it out.
There you go.
That's right.
Corey says, how nervous is the cop when you get pulled over for a speeding ticket? Corey, there's a good comment to that. A good answer.
I get a good story. Do you want me to tell the return story?
Well, because it's not a regular everyday vehicle, right?
No, it's not a daily driver. This vehicle is something that's only used at events. Well, we use it for training. It's the thing sees, what, 5,000 miles a year? And most of that is highway going to and from events. It's just not a daily driver. Obviously, it came down from Denver to Colorado Springs today. But, yeah, we don't drive it outside of events hardly ever. Being someone who has a background in law enforcement, you know, we keep it legal with what's on the vehicle.
We push the limits a little bit for what would be appropriate, but we want to keep it so that we can go to several states at once and not worry about having our truck impounded.
Yeah. A lot of those, the functions that you see on the vehicle are disabled and cannot be enabled until we get to an event. We specifically take some steps to activate them.
Okay. Ethan Vaughn keeps trying to... Oh, wait. We have a phone call.
Do we have a phone call?
Yeah, we do.
Oh, no.
Uh-oh.
Thanks for calling the Valken Debrief. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
That's.
Hey, I'm actually a brigade member, but
I just called.
I'm actually the captain now. My name's Kong. How's it going, guys?
So, if you guys don't know who this is Kong. Yeah. Twitch recently stepped down as team captain
because
he has some personal stuff going on, and we elected a new captain this fall. This is Kong, who's actually the leader of the team. We are just members of the team.
Wait, Kong, are you Asian?
Yes,
I am Asian.
Oh, let's hear some of that Asian dialect.
Yeah.
Well, so here's a funny Kong story.
I got to pull my thing off because of the stream delay here. I just blew my cover. I thought this was private. I didn't realize I'd be on the stream.
No, you're live, dude. Whatever you say, everyone hears it.
You know, before this started, we were saying that you were going to come in and start screaming at us in Korean like you did to JP at Broken Home.
So here's a fun Kong story for you guys. We sent Kong up Broken Home this year to turn. We normally turn all our registrations in a big packet. Makes things easier for us, easier for AMS. So tip, if you have a team, get all your stuff together, turn it in together, makes your life a lot easier.
Yeah.
AMS really appreciates that. So we sent Kong up in his first event to go up to the registration booth at Broken Home and just start screaming in Korean at JP. And you watch JP just freeze. And he was just asking, like, please get, I want some service. But he's just screaming in Korean as loud as possible.
Kong, you're my new hero.
And JP is just making this face like he has no clue what's going on. Just lost in the sauce.
It was great.
So a million
JP
cool
still
points.
Doesn't understand who I am. So, you know, every time I see him, he's just like, who is this guy? He's 7 times now.
So, Kong, you called in. What do you want to ask or say or tell us? I mean, any juicy tidbits on these two knuckleheads?
You can talk trash about us, man.
So many juicy tidbits. But now that my cover's blown, I guess I was just wondering if you guys were having a good time out there.
Well, first of all, we are really sad you did not come down. The fact that you picked work over airsoft, we're really disappointed in you.
I know, I'm actually working as I'm talking to you guys. Ooh, and that's
busted. Busted.
Yep. Yep.
So, before we lose Kong, we just want to put this out there. Kong had his first event in the leadership position at Ranger Games, did an awesome job. Led the team, represented us.
Wait, that was Kong?
Yeah, that little Asian guy, that was Kong, yeah. Yeah, who rolls around, was just jumping in and out of buildings. He's like a ninja, man. And I'm not saying that to be racist. I'm saying that like he is, like, has ninja-like skills. He just appears places. It's great.
So. Yeah. Genetic. No. No, I hope you guys are having a great time. Awesome show so far. So, keep it up, guys.
If you haven't been on the show, you haven't lived in airsoft. I'm just telling you right now. Like you're
I know,
like,
right?
You're not saying you've been on the show.
I know.
You'd be good, brother.
All right. You guys take care.
Catch
you
later, dude.
I told you he was going to do that. But we were talking about that like at lunch today, like saying Kong's going to call in, try and be all incognito.
Oh my gosh.
Woodcock says Kong and the Ream did great work at Reindeer Games.
Was there reaming that I didn't know about?
Like, I know.
Was there command stuff?
Woodcock's talking about reaming. We're talking about Roadhead.
I saw some pretty awful stuff on one of those.
You know.
Have we just degenerated your show down to just chaos?
Or? So we've gotten up to 35 viewers. So we need to get that back up to 50 so we can give away some luggage.
Just so you guys know, if you guys don't get these prizes, I'm taking them home. They got to get given out. So if you don't want me to have them, get your friends on the show watching right now. Get you some free stuff.
I do have
you,
them in
you
there.
You don't want him to have them.
I'll go get them right now and tease you with them. I'll do it right now. They're right over there. The production assistants are getting them ready, cleaning them off for me, sanitizing. I will do it right now and show this stuff that you can't have if you don't get your friends.
So call the phone number. It's right there on the screen if you got a question. I actually posted up a new poll. Should Brigade Milsim attend a Centurion Milsim event?
And oh, look at that.
That is an overwhelming yes.
92%. I'm going to publish those results. 92%.
Wow. Here's the next poll that we should go for that. Do you want to fight against us, or do you want us on your side? No, I really want to know.
Oh, well,
yeah.
That is... you fought with us and against us. What is?
Oh, that's right. That's sort of so. Broken Home 5.
Yep. Yep.
I was one of the UFS company commanders. Woody was my XO in denial. we fought a lot together between the bridge and Colville.
A lot of time in Colville. A lot of time in Colville.
Yep.
And then that area in between Pegasus and Colville that always gets into crazy fights there.
I mean, the one thing I loved, it was like, I didn't have to tell you, you know, if Colville was a Humvee and you had to paint it pink, I didn't care if you painted it up and down, side to side, airbrushed it. I'd be like, right here, I need this. Right now, and you were like, got it, boom. It's like you didn't ask questions, you didn't like argue, it was just like boom. And that was really great.
I'll tell you, working for people, that was my first event. And actually, here's a quick side note, guys. So I started playing Airsoft in January of 2015. And I had a couple times out at a local field. It wasn't very satisfying. Due to my background, I want to work with people, you know. I want to have a team of guys that's more fun than just running around on your own. So I found the team, joined. They took me down to this crazy event in Oklahoma known as Broken Home, which is also should be on your bucket list. It's huge. There's like a million people there. The terrain is harsh. It's hot.
There's ticks. Hot.
It'll test you. And so Twitch is walking me around saying all these people I've seen on the internet, videos, this and that. Who's the first person I meet of all of the, are we calling you Airsoft celebrities, should we call it? Or personalities, what are we calling it? Notable Airsoft people. And the first person I met was Rob right here, the Kaiju himself, who then introduced me around to Woodcock and all the people hanging around from US Command. And that was my introduction to high-level Airsoft, was I got to meet the people who run everything. And I got to see a really good insight to it. So this is kind of a full circle trip for me that I got to meet Kaiju when I started in Airsoft. And I'm not done in Airsoft, but I think I've kind of come full circle that now I'm on your show. It's kind of rad, you know. So.
Oh, I appreciate it. That's awesome.
To answer that question, working for a command group that understands the capabilities of them, people working for them. So
that wasn't the question.
Was it?
No, your question. So let's get back to the question.
Sorry, man. I'm lost.
So, it was great working with you.
Yes, yep. It's great working
then
for
I
you.
Had the opportunity to command against you.
Yep.
At Copperhead.
How was Copperhead that? 2, I think.
2.5.
Yeah, not 2, 2.5.
The rescheduled 2.5.
The rescheduled
And that was very challenging. I had a great... Too Tall Tom was my spotter.
He is.
And his one job was to call you jackasses out. Wherever you went... So I could send another truck that way. I mean, because you guys had your truck, and then there was a red truck.
Yeah.
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 Yeah. I think we only had two that event.
Yeah. It's actually, wherever you guys went, it was like, I don't care. Send our truck that way, wherever they're going.
And actually, that was the event that we went up against Woody and Robo. They were playing green that year with you guys.
Yes, they were.
And Woody actually burned out his gun against us in that firefight. It's in Robo's video. Yeah.
Melted the trigger contacts.
Melted the trigger contacts trying to keep us out of
the
house.
You must have had Woodcock on the ropes, man. He was worried.
I suggest you go watch that video. It was a quality Airsoft video.
And Woody, if you want to see the video from our side, we've got several angles.
Is it really?
Yeah, Woodcock says Brigade caught him and Robo in a house.
Yep.
It was a good fight.
Over on Montana
really good
Street.
Fight.
Yeah. Oh, man. Let's see. What other... There were some other questions in here, man. People want the backpack. You got to get more people in here.
I know.
Greg Alexander says, at Copperhead, Brigade was my Uber.
Yeah.
Greg did hang out in our truck all weekend.
I think Greg and Cody, we drove
Cody
around
and Greg
quite a
were
bit.
Pretty much in our back seat the entire weekend. We put up a lot of cameras in that event. I think we put 17 up or something like that.
And I was going to show the Humvee takedown, and I went to go look for it, and I realized I forgot to download it. So I apologize for that. It is on their YouTube channel.
On our YouTube channel, just search Brigade Milsim, and yeah, you'll find it.
Brigade Milsim on YouTube, Brigade Milsim on Facebook. We have tons of good videos of us going up against technicals and us getting our butts kicked by technicals and dismounts.
Yeah.
There's just as much. If you want to see a great video, the end of Broken Home this year, I don't know if you heard this story at Kaiju, but all the mounted vehicles did a like balls out rush at the Koss lines and the north of Colville, and it is just one vehicle after another being wiped out as it charges their lines in an oil.
Yeah, we were given an assignment that we had to get to Pegasus Bridge, and Koss had the north end of Colville just locked down. And so we just decided, you know what, we got 15 minutes left, let's just hit it with everything we got, convoy in, and boy, we just got annihilated.
So we, at the end of that fight, we got some audio software on the video we had from inside the cab, and we took 1,700 rounds in like 6 seconds.
Oh my gosh!
Yeah, it was.
Was I right in the numbers?
Like, I think it was like 16 seconds.
16 seconds. I might be off on the
number. So don't forget, we have the phone number. Call in 856-975-0650.
Trash. Ask questions.
Ask your questions. Ethan Vaughn has a question. So, do vehicles switch sides? I thought some place had a flag capture point that if it was on your color, you could use that vehicle.
Okay, well, that's so, interesting. Ethan, that's a good question. At the American Milsim events, I'm typically the platoon leader for UFS for all the mechanized units, which are the vehicle units. And we're out there, we've got typically between 2 to 6 vehicles. And so each faction has their own vehicles. And they stay with that faction the whole time. They're not something that is captured and transferred from side to side.
Also,
and hold on, Chris. Thanks for calling the Valken Debrief. What's your name and where are you calling from?
Hey, this is A-Train from Muscle Shoals, Alabama.
What's up, A-Train?
Nothing much. What's the prize tonight?
Oh, it's the Valken Phantom duffel bag. And you can backpack.
Two bodies.
It's
pretty sweet looking.
Two bodies in
two,
that.
Two dead bodies.
Two dead bodies at least. Like
three if you chop.
Three
if they're.
That's if we hit 50 viewers. Okay. And then if we hit 100, we're going to give away a rifle with a rechargeable stock.
Ooh.
All right, well, cool. I just brought in like 25 people, so Centurion Milsim.
Oh, I'm sorry. Thanks for calling.
Oh, you're gone. I'm sorry.
Oh.
Can we get him back on the line? Can we get
I know,
that?
Right?
Oh, it's sad.
Man, we had some technical difficulties. We lost A-Train from YouTube. I'm so
this
sorry.
This production team is trash. That is just ridiculous.
I don't know what happened. But, yeah, there was another call coming in. Please feel free to call back.
So to tack on to that, guys, the biggest question that people have at events when they go to the Safety Breeze, Weasel AMS, is how do I get a ticket to ride on one of the vehicles? And the biggest myth that you have to debunk for people is these are all privately funded. They're all people bringing these out there to use themselves. It's the equivalent of saying, hey man, can I use your gun for the day? You know, so just keep that in mind when you're out there.
All right, let's try this again. Thanks for calling the Valken Debrief. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
It's Woody.
Oh, it's Woodcock! We're not worthy!
No, okay, we're done. We're on. Show's over.
We just broke the internet.
The internet's gone. How you doing, big guy?
Hey, I just wanted to call in and say I love Brigade. They're awesome guys. I recommend them to anybody, any day of the week, to be on their team. We have fought against them. Absolutely hated every minute of it. Yes.
That's great.
Literally, I've got the video from Robo and I in the house on the Alamo showdown, and it was painful.
You guys were kicking our ass in that house, man. Like we
tried everything. It was hard. I literally, me and Robo were both medics, and we literally went back and forth medicing ourselves.
That was the same house that kid smothered the grenade with our shield, if you remember.
Yes.
Yeah.
That was a painful day.
Ooh.
That was a good fight, though.
So Woody, our good friend Corey is in the chat, and he's asking you guys, so how much to ride? Leo replies, Chapstick is how you get a ride. Tim Green says, I will pay 25 schmeckles to ride.
This is,
but Woodcock knows all about the chapstick.
Boy, we need to start selling
tickets
for this thing.
Listen, chapstick, you have to, if you're any kind of vet that's been out in the field a lot, you got to have chapstick. So,
that's how you get the good vision.
It's just one of those things, and I got a great picture of me and Bubba Moore with, you know, with some chapstick. So,
if you Photoshop the chapstick out, it looks like they're kissing. They're about to kiss.
Yeah.
Here you go.
Robert Fritz says, Woody, you're not supposed to call, quote, goober. Fritz just called you a goober.
He called you a goober?
Yeah, Fritz just called you a goober, Woody.
That's fighting's words. Like, what's the address here? Tell him to come on down. Hey, we'll deal with that.
People call me all kinds of names. It doesn't
matter. I just want to say
it's usually asshole, but that's all right.
For our audience out here, if you guys don't know who Woody is, and there's no reason that you shouldn't, because he's on this show like three times a week, apparently. Woody is an awesome AMS personality. He's commanded. He's been combat control. He brings a level of professionalism to the game that if you want that in your games, he's going to provide that. And if he's commanding a faction, you want to be on that faction. He's our favorite guy to play for because he just lets us do whatever the hell we want. So, you know,
I didn't call in for all that. That wasn't my reason. I was calling in to praise Brigade. I love those guys.
I'm sorry,
they
I can't
actually
help
do awesome
you
work. And Chris is, Chris Nielson does amazing map work for us. Anybody that's played UFS or Unit has seen the products that his team has always produced. And just an amazing, probably some of the hardest working, hardest training group of guys I've ever met. So,
you're embarrassing
us
here, man. You're embarrassing us to death, dude.
Nah.
No, this is how we get Woody back. Everybody in the chat that's watching, right? Hashtag thank you for your service, Woody. Show Woody some love. Hit that heart button. He's a military vet.
He's an airsoft vet.
And I'm giving you a bunch of hearts and one
O-face.
I'm sorry,
out.
Cav. What? I'm what? Oh, we lost connection.
Woodcock, I want to say I appreciate it a lot. That means a lot. We love working with you at these events.
And now that you can't talk back. Follow us. Just follow me, Woody. It's okay. Just follow me.
I don't know what's going on with the phone board tonight.
If you're not a vet, you probably don't get that joke, but ask a friend.
We got Yako.
Who's Yako? Oh, did we lose it?
Well, he asked. He's all the way from South Africa.
Oh, wow. Cool.
And then I just lost the question.
Yako,
but, okay. Corey Parsons, what was the beginning of the truck? What event or who had the idea? Who started building Chaos
okay,
One?
So,
where did it start?
Boy, back in the day in 2011 when the team started, we had a team member that had a little Toyota, I think it was a T22 truck that we used at a event in Camp Guernsey, Wyoming. And boy, that was the start of it, where we had a small vehicle. We realized the utility of it. It was great for a couple of years, and we didn't have a vehicle actually for about 2 years. In 2015 is when that vehicle came about. And we took a lot of the aspects from the old vehicle, like the side panels, some of the equipment, how some of the interiors configured, and we incorporated that into the new vehicle. The biggest benefit I think of having that truck is not having to walk as much.
Yeah.
And that's always been a motivator to keep it going.
it's hard to explain to people who haven't played the style that we get to play with the truck, which is, we go really hard for like 5 minutes at a time. We either win or route, and then we go and respawn. Yep. And it allows us to be way more bursty in how we play out there. Instead of a lot of the dismounted teams, how they have to worry about traveling from here and there, we can show up, hit a target, we either win or we get our butts kicked, and just do it all over again. You know, it's just airsoft.
At these at the big events that we go to, typically we do between about 15 and 25 what we call field cycles, which is we leave the fob, we go out, we do something, and then we end up back. That's a field cycle. We end up doing 15 to 20 of those. And so anytime we're at the fob to rehab, for refill water, refill magazines, we're only there for 10, maybe 15 minutes.
That's a long stop.
And then we're back out in the field. And some of those field cycles that we're out there for are 15 minutes, and sometimes it's 2.5-3 hours. It depends on what we're doing.
Oh, we got a call.
Awesome.
Hey, thanks for calling the Valken Debrief. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
Hey, what's up, man? My name is Rico. I'm calling from Florida, Gator Paintball.
What's up? Hey, what's up, Rico?
Hey, what's up, guys? Just checking in, man. Just logged in for the first time to watch your show today. Pretty cool.
This is the best
to see that you guys have a show going with Airsoft as well. I know that your counterpart in the paintball, and Andrew, is doing the paintball A-Train, and he usually he's doing a good job on that as well.
Yes,
and
I've expanded to call it our sister show.
Yeah, there you go. He's the sister, all right, man. He's a good sister.
He is a good sister. Anyway. So, do you have a question or anything? Like, or are you starting?
Yeah, yeah. So listen, absolutely.
He's BB curious. Oh, he's BB curious.
Yeah, good.
I'm sorry, using that term.
You know, my question really is basically I've opened up Gator Paintball or Airsoft, and recently I've had a turnout of some teams, local teams that are playing in a very small piece of land, and so they're starting to come out. And but I've had, you know, very sporadic success. So there's weekends I'll have 30, 40 people out there, and, you know, sometimes not too many. But I'm trying to bring in, I don't know if there's a fine line between these teams and rec ball when it comes to airsoft rec ball. And I know there's a difference. Is there any advice you guys can give me? Should I try
to
track
ball? Scenario MagFed is very close to airsoft scenario. You know, you could take some of the same rules for skirmishing for paintball and just apply them to airsoft. You just are not marked, you know, with paint.
So we're going through this in Colorado Springs right now.
Yeah, we are going through this in Colorado Springs.
So we had a lot of fields in the Springs in the Denver area for a long time out here, and they all kind of went away for one reason or another, and they're coming back now. And the way they come back normally is paintball fields start opening up
airsoft. Yep.
And
yep.
So you're in a very similar position to a lot of fields when they try to expand. And so, speaking from a player point of view, your teams for the most part are going to be focused on national level events. There are lots of local teams that just kind of get together and play, and there's nothing wrong with that. But when you're talking about teams and what they're expecting, you're talking about like national level teams. And that's, I mean, unfortunately in a local field, you're just going to not be able to provide everything they want for destination type play. To get people out every day to your field and to local play, what I look for is a staff that is talking to the players and asking what they're looking at of the day. Like, what game do you guys want to run next? You guys want to do a capture the flag or a pushback, or we're going to do a VIP game. Games that are really popular is you find a couple guys who are girls, who are very into the sport and been doing it a while, do a veterans versus everybody else game. So have like 8 people who've been playing for a couple years, put them in a castle and defend against everybody else with unlimited lives. There's lots of ways that you can use a small amount of experienced players to provide a good experience for players that are not out there very often. And the other thing too is that familiar yourself with what airsoft rules are on local fields. Go out and play on other fields that are airsoft only. There's a lot of issues we run into in going to play on paintball fields where, for instance, barrel bags are a thing. And you might get some pushback on that because we're not used to having barrel bags required. Our guns have safeties and you can remove the magazines very visibly.
He means barrel bags, barrel covers, yeah. Barrel condoms.
And I'm not saying it's a bad thing. I think it's more safety is a great thing. I'm just saying if you get some weird looks from airsoft players, it's because we're not always used to that. Face protection. Airsoft, traditionally, if you're over 18, iPro is all that's required in most fields, full seal. And your lower face mask and ear pro, that's your decision. And so just understand that if you get some weird looks about wanting a face mask on people, a lot of airsofters don't run face masks. I'm one of them.
Well, under 18 required to have...
And so I'm fine with all that. But I always find it shocking that paintball people open up to airsoft and they assume it's exactly the same as paintball. They don't get that there's two distinct cultures. And in the same way, I wouldn't open up to paintball and, you know, not have, and because I would realize that there's a different culture. Yeah.
Hey, and Rico, we're going to put you in touch with, RJ, Yonk. He owns a field as well. And, he's been very successful with introducing airsoft at his field. And so we're going to have A-Train send you a message and put you in contact with RJ, and he'll be able to definitely give you some tips and help you out, brother.
Okay. That's
also,
fantastic.
We're available if you need us.
Well,
fantastic.
Thanks for calling in, Rico. Keep
you
data going.
It. Thank you, guys.
Keep it going. Keep all it alive.
Right. All right. Well, I think that's about all the time we have.
Ooh, did we run over?
Did we go over?
Yeah, we went over. That's okay. Because I have a little automatic draft from our sister show on Tuesdays. So I get 12 minutes of their time this week or next week. Because this is the end of the week. That's why I like going after them.
So you can steal their time.
Yes. So whatever they don't use, I get that surplus.
I'm okay with that. That's
because we don't have rollover minutes to the next week. So I use up what they did.
Does Facebook have rollover minutes now?
It does. It does. Facebook has rollover minutes. So thank you all for joining. We didn't quite hit 50 players or viewers. But you know what?
Give it to
them. Airsoft Innovations. We got a bunch of stuff donated from them because they're big. We're going to give away an XL burst grenade to a lucky winner. Ooh, awesome. You know, because we still, just because we only got to 35, those 35 shouldn't have to suffer because we didn't get 50.
You get something for showing up. Door prizes are how Airsoft works.
Heck yeah.
Yeah.
And we're supposed to have white elephant gifts tonight. What happened?
White elephant? Oh.
And our hammer comment of the night. It's going to go to Angela Scott.
And what was her comment? Did we still have that up?
Oh, she was talking about the Roadhead.
Oh, the Roadhead. I'll deal with that.
Yeah.
That was incredibly inappropriate, and I approve.
You know, I mean, they had some great hammer comments, but she literally walked up to that line,
if you're still
looked over the edge.
And you see us at an event, or we're at a local field, track us down. I got some swag for you. That was our kind of inappropriate. I got some brigade swag for you.
So, Angela, we'll get you out a t-shirt. So, we have to pick... a random comment to win an XL burst grenade. And so let's see, how
anybody curse in their comment, I'll get my vote.
Let's see,
if you said nudes, that might help you out, guys. There's still time in the show, just saying.
Oh my gosh. And it lands on Ethan Vaughn.
Ooh, what was his comment?
No, it's just
it's just a random comment.
The more you comment,
the more you can win.
So yeah, awesome. Figure out how to Ethan Vaughn, you won an Airsoft Innovations XL Burst Grenade.
Congrats.
Congratulations. All you have to do to claim that prize, head over to www.valkenalliance.com and sign up. It's free. And then I will reach out to you tomorrow, verify your shipping address, and we'll get that XL Burst Grenade out to you.
Lucky winner.
I know, lucky winner.
Lucky winner.
So, thank you guys for joining us tonight.
Thanks for having us.
Dude, it was fun. Awesome.
This is the highlight of my airsoft career at this point, I think. this is the coolest thing I've done.
Well, dude, you can't make this. You can go up, bro. First of all,
if you guys don't know about this show, there is a green room back there that has snacks and craft services.
The gummies are awesome, aren't they?
They're fantastic. They're Haribo. If you eat anything but a Haribo gummy, you should go to hell.
We are in Colorado.
Yeah, I have to say it.
So be sure to follow us on social media on Facebook, Instagram. We have both Valken Airsoft and Valken Alliance.
And please check us out at Brigade Milsim at youtube.com, Brigades Milsim on Facebook. I think that's all where we are right now. Yeah.
Yeah. And Airsoft Secret. It's all one word. Brigade Milsim on Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube.
Yep.
Yep.
Yeah. Support these guys because they're out there supporting you with all their guns, and you never know. The next time you dehydrate at a broken home event, all you remember is this tan truck
water
pulling up and these dudes just throwing you in the back. That's these guys right here.
That's happened a time
or
20.
If there is one lesson that I leave you with here, drink water. I am tired of treating heat drops. Drink water, exercise before you come out. It's the biggest problem in airsoft. It's hot out there and it's a long day.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you for joining us. Be sure to join us next week for episode number 69.
We coming back?
Yeah, we're coming back. We're driving out to SHOT Show. We're just going to steal it.
We'll
just do that
I guess Darth Valken just lost his job.
We're just going to knock him out. We'll just take
have a good night, everyone. We'll catch you later.
Airsoft Con 2018. Valken.
Oh, yeah. NATO.
Hey, it's Kaiju. I'm the Supreme Commander, that's what I am.
Move!
Get to the freaking bunker town, let's go!
It's all right.
Hey, this is Dave with Blue Lines.
You start too early.
Oh, I thought you were good.
No, you, there's a delay when I hit the button.
Okay.
All right, now we're good.
We're going to go over tank busting using tagging rounds. Airborne.
Yeah, we'll come back.
Stop filming. Stop filming. Stop filming. Stop filming.